So you want to import images as planes in Blender 2.8. Hey guys, welcome back to TutsByKai. I'm Kai, and today we are back in Blender once again, taking a look at how to import images as planes in Blender. We'll go ahead and hit delete on my keyboard to delete the cube because we don't need it. I'm going to go ahead and select our camera, hit Alt-G, Alt-R, RX, 90 to rotate the camera 90 degrees on the X-axis. And then GY to move it backwards. So we just clear the rotation location and hit 90 on my numpad, RX. All right, so we'll go ahead and hit edit to hit preferences, and then we'll go ahead and type in search images, and then make sure images as planes is checked. We'll go ahead and hit save preferences and hit the X to close that on out because we don't need it anymore. Now, we can hit shift A to add in an image, images as planes. Now, what we're going to do is go to the image that you're looking for, and we can move this piece on up. Now, we don't need any of this stuff right now, but we will in a second here. So we'll go ahead and select our image, which is this guy. So if we hit this little thumbnail button, we can see the thumbnails. We'll go ahead and select this guy because this is our image. We'll import that, and we can hit S to scale it on up. Go to the render tab right there, render viewport shading. You can see that we have our image. S to scale it up. We'll select our lamp, hit G. So we can see a bit easier. Zero to go into my camera's view. Now you can see we have that image. It works perfectly. If I hit render image, you can see that the image will render. So that's the way it is right there. But now we want a transparent image. Maybe you want a transparent background for your image. Maybe you have some kind of logo or something. We'll go ahead and hit shift A to actually let's move this backwards. So I hit GY on that to move backwards. Hit shift A, images as planes, and we can open up the transparent background. You can see my logo does have a transparent background behind it. You see the difference there? It has the little pieces up in the top and in the middle and stuff. Now we have to make sure this use alpha is checked over here. Make sure this use alpha is checked, and then we can go ahead and hit images and import images as planes. Now you can see that it has a black background behind it, which is not what we need. The way we can fix this is we can go to the material tab and make sure we go to blend mode and change the blend mode from opaque to blend to alpha blend. Now you can see if we click that, the background will be completely transparent. Now if we scale this up by hitting S, rotate it, RX, double tap R, sorry, scale it on up even more, bring it out. You can see that if we were to go ahead and render this, it looks nice. And we can see behind there, but you can see we have a problem because the shadow is still a shadow of the transparent of the actual plane. So if we can fix that by going to shadow mode and changing this from opaque to alpha hashed. Now we can either do alpha hashed or that you see that, let me move it closer. There we go. Now you can see we have that alpha hashed right there. Now we can see the actual shadow of just the actual logo, which is nice. We can also do alpha clip, but it's not going to work exactly the same way. You can see it looks the same, but it does have some different properties there. You can do either one if you really want to, as long as it's one of the ones that say alpha. So that looks good. The clip threshold, you can see if I were to turn up the threshold, and we can clip it out. Just like how you can do in the camera's view, we can clip that out at a certain degree backwards if you don't want to see it from farther away than a certain degree. But if you don't care about that, just leave it on alpha hashed, and then you don't have to worry about any clipping or anything like that. So that's going to be it for today. I hope you guys and girls enjoyed it. If you did, make sure you let me know down below. I'll see you guys in the next one. But until then, bye-bye.